stars of night. I will make the darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold
your people in my heart. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Marie died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. As we come together today, I first want to welcome everyone here for this funeral mass for Marie. We're very thankful for all the support that you are showing the family today, for all those friends here and acquaintances and people who knew and love her and love her family. We're very thankful that you're here. Let us now gather ourselves in prayer and let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant, Marie, also find new strength through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated, and at this time, we'll have some words of remembrance.
Marie is very religious. I say she is religious because Marie believes in God the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and eternal life in heaven. And by God's grace, we're here today to celebrate her life and pray that she is reunited with her husband, Joe, and loved ones who passed before her. Marie taught me that God is important, Jesus is important, and faith is important. I was in these pews as a kid and have fond memories of her son Gary and husband Joe as ushers here at St. Paul's. Marie was a member of the Paulites and also taught CCD here at St. Paul's. Marie, daughter of Mary and John Janes, was born May 4th, 1926, 3 years before the Great Depression. When she was 15, the Depression ended in 1941, and by 19, when World War II ended in 1945, 2 years after that, Marie married the love of her life, Joe Videtic. They went on to have two sons, James and Gary. Marie was admired by her nieces and nephews, Dave, Jane, Jackie, Jill, Jimmy, Lori, Marianne, Jeff, Johnny, Scott, and Mike. As I reflect on today and how much I realize how much I admire my cousins and their parents, Marie's sister Rosella and her husband Bill, sister Betty and her husband Jack, brother John, and his wife Sharon. Marie had a zest for life. Her secret to life at 97 was don't stop moving, and she lived it. Marie won a Pi Award in the 1950s. She became a snowbird after her husband Joe passed away in 1989, enjoying time in Arizona with her sister-in-law Jean. Marie loved to play golf, is a proud recipient of 2 holes-in-1. She loved water skiing even at the age of 80. Marie toured Europe with the family, took the family to Maui, took the family to on an Alaskan cruise and Caribbean cruises, traveled to Wisconsin every summer to visit her grandson Dennis and his wife Tina, and her great-grandchildren Dylan and Carly. In the winter, Marie lived in Arizona with her son Gary and son James, his wife Becky, grandson Brian, his wife Allie, and great-grandson Vaughn, and granddaughter Tara. Marie never missed a Cubs game, a football game, a hockey game, or a chance for adventure. She loved to dance, cheered on the World Series and Super Bowl, and was still meeting weekly with groups of friends in Arizona and Illinois to play cards and Farkle. She loved doing puzzles with Gary and Jimmy and visiting Jimmy. Marie's loved by her family. She's loved by all of you and will be greatly missed. Please keep her spirit alive. Don't stop moving. Be kind, be giving, and forgiving. It's hard to sum up the life of a 97-year-old in 3 minutes. But I'll miss her very much.
And at this time, we will have our first reading.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Protect it.
one near, standing always at my side. You guard me from afar, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I'd find you there. Oh, you know my heart and its ways. You who formed me before I was born, in the secret of darkness, before I saw the sun, in my mother's womb. Oh Lord, I know
this time we'll have our second reading.
What is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. A reading from the second letter from St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this momentary light affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison. As we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen. For what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. For we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. now, and to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
On one occasion, Jesus spoke thus, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. And you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning. Again, I'd like to bring our many prayers and condolences on behalf of St. Paul Parish family here to your family. I just know that you are all in our prayers, that Marie is in our prayers this day. And a little bit before Mass, I walked back there and I took some time to look at the two picture boards that were back there. And the picture boards in and of themselves tell a remarkable story. Aside from all the other things that I have learned about Marie over the last few days, and I think that the scripture, the gospel today, is really a perfect one to kind of describe her. Jesus talks about in the gospel today that he's revealed himself to those who are childlike. Who are childlike. And that's an amazing quality to have in life, being childlike. And that's what I saw back there on those picture boards. I saw a woman who was smiling and having fun with her kids and grandkids and great-grandkids and doing incredible things at even an old age, you know? Water skiing and snow skiing and going to all these different sporting events for her grandchildren and there was even a photograph back there that made me smile. She's sitting on a race car on a go-kart, and she's ready to go, and that's the heart of what it means to be childlike. And now she would have told people the secret to a long life is her faith. You have to have faith. But the secret to being childlike is surrounding herself with the children in her life. You guys kept her young. You realize how young you kept your mom, your grandmother, your great-grandmother, just by being present in her life and by giving her new energy every single day. That's an amazing gift, because we already know she's given you guys so much, but it's mutual. You gave her a great deal in return. And that's that loving exchange that God gives families, is the ability for those of us who have grown a little gray, our job is to pass on wisdom. And her job was to pass on wisdom to you guys, and she did that very well. Your job is to pass your youth on to her and keep her young, and you've done that so well. And so we celebrate her today. And we also, I think, can maybe look to St. Paul today, who tells us a little bit in his letter to the Corinthians about what this promise is that God has for us, that you know, he is that he's creating a place for us, a dwelling from God, not made with hands, eternal in heaven. And so today, which we're still in this Easter season, and we're still celebrating the Lord's resurrection. And so in a special way today, in this Easter season, we also celebrate that promise of resurrection is very real to Marie, that she gets to feel the full weight of what it means to meet her Lord and to know him in a very personal way. You know, all those over the years, all those prayers that she said, all those rosaries that she said were leading up to this moment. Leading up to this moment, the moment that she gets to meet God face to face. And so that's what we celebrate today. Each of you in your own way have had wonderful experiences and memories and times that you shared with Marie. I would invite you very quietly in your own heart before we go into our prayers of the faithful. Maybe just think about one or two of those memories that's special to you, and we'll kind of offer up all of those silently during our prayers today. Let us now stand together as we bring our prayers and petitions before God, the Almighty Father, and I would invite those readers of the petitions to come forward at this time.
For Marie, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, especially Marie's beloved husband, Joseph Videtic, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our grandmother Marie, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our grandmother Marie, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, we thank you for hearing our prayers this day as we lift them up to you. We ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Gentlewoman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look favorably on the offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Marie may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in yes.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim
your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Ronald, our Bishop, Daniel, our retired Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen,
amen, amen,
amen,
amen,
amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign.
Peace with you, John.
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb
of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ.
Who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in
Christ.
His shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge,
the body of Christ.
My rock,
the body
in
of Christ.
Whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. There you are,
the body of Christ.
Make you to shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you. Raise you up on eagles.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Marie, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Marie. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. This time, I would invite you to extend your hand forward with me in a gesture of blessing. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our sister Marie in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Marie in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do see the face of God and leave. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk